All right, thanks, Will. Well, Boat Week continues here on the Rhode Show, and some students from Tiverton High School are being recognized for their work creating a boat and creating something called Quahog Man. Yeah, we're going to tell you more about it in just a second, but we are joined now by some of the instructors and one of the students. Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Thanks so much for being here. Zach, let's start with you. Tell us a little bit about your role in this creation of the boat and the project here.
I'm the engineering teacher at Tiverton High School. My students help design and come up with all the dimensions and everything else of the boat. And then that goes on to Mr. Phillips for him to build.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so Bill, that brings us to you. So right. Once that comes together, tell us about this
boat. A wooden 10.5-foot rowboat. It's made from mahogany and marine-grade plywood. It's a nice rowing boat. This is one of the projects that the younger kids build.
Mm-hmm.
As they get into their 11th and 12th grade year, they build a 16-foot Quahog skiff that kind of ties in with the Quahog Man. So it's a really nice program. We have kids that have opportunities at jobs and going on to college, and it's really fun.
How long does it take to build something like this?
It takes about 3 months to build a 10.5-foot boat.
Comes together quickly.
Yeah, and pretty quickly. And then the 16-foot boat takes about 4.5 months.
All right. So a lot of work, of course, on the boat and of Quahog Man. So, Aiden, that brings us to you. What was it like creating these two projects?
Unfortunately, I didn't have anything to do with Quahog Man. But the boats, they're just great. It really just kind of helps you kind of get into the design and just build aspect of things, kind of mm-hmm. giving you some life experience with what it would be like to build some of this. It's just a fun experience, and it's great to do with everybody else, too.
Yeah, I bet. A lot of creativity, too, going behind it. Did you realize just how lengthy of a process this was beforehand?
Kind of, not really, because you kind of grow up in the high school. You kind of see a bunch of other kids doing it,
yeah,
and when you're
true.
Interested, you ask them about it, and it is a bit of a process, but it's also not too hard, and it's fun while doing it.
Mm-hmm. Also fun is Quahog Man. Adam, first of all, tell us about who this is and what he does.
We were asked to build a installation for a outdoor park in Newport.
Mm-hmm.
So I basically presented the idea to some of my art students, and they tried to come up with something that everyone in the area could sort of connect to. So they came up with Quahog Man. They drew him up. We had Zach's engineering students kind of design them.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Phillips' students helped build them, and then my students painted them and drew them up.
And very cool that the cogs that he's holding in that net, they're real, right?
They are. Actually, they're from when we built them, we actually put a clam oil on, so while we were working, we had something to eat afterwards.
And, get out. What a fun project.
Yeah.
And again, the size of him, it's huge. The details are great. How long did it take for our class to paint this?
It took a couple hours, a couple days after school. I have a group of kids that stay mm-hmm. after with us, and it was a ton of fun, and he's been all over. He'll be at the Bristol Boat Show this weekend.
Great. Yeah. Well, you'd be on the lookout for that if you're headed out to the boat show. Aiden, for you, do you think this is a good class, the boat building, to just kind of expand the minds of a lot of students if folks are interested?
It's great. It's a great class to take. You really learn a lot in it, and
mm-hmm.
it's also great when you get to learn some of the creative stuff too by taking art with this. You kind of get a whole well-rounded aspect to your just knowledge and all that. It's great.
Ties two worlds together. Yeah, that's right. Well, one last look at Quahog Man over there in that beautiful boat too. So if you'd like more information about Quahog Man or even the Rhode Island Boat Show happening this weekend, head on over to the Rhode Show page at WPRI.com.